Dave, Ricky's been at home for several months now. How's it feel to have him back?
Oh, it's fantastic to have him back. Going to the hospital every day was... It took its toll on everybody. To be home with him all the time is just fantastic. He's improving week by week, and the physios at the hospital are really happy with the way he has progressed. A lot of the hospital staff can't believe how far he's come from where he was at the start of it, obviously. And to see him with his sparkle back in his eye again, because he's at home, it's just fantastic. And he keeps improving week by week. The physios are happy with that. And it's just great. It's just great to see him come so far. He's still got a long, long way to go, obviously, but it's just fantastic. That's all I can say, really. He's doing great.
And Ricky, I've just been watching you playing FIFA 15. Yeah. Doing a great job there. You're obviously getting good at that.
Yeah, I'm getting there, should I say. I'm getting there, but he can't beat me.
No, I've heard you can't beat him at all at this game, so clearly you need more practice.
Yeah, well, I don't mind being Manchester City. If you're Manchester United, you can beat me all day, mate. I don't make it easy for you, though, do I?
No.
There's a lot going on when he's playing that game. There's a lot of thought going into it, and it's good. It's good for him. There's a lot of buttons to press to make that game work.
Yeah.
And he, you know, considering he's got a brain injury, he can beat me. He beat me 8-1 the other night. Like I say, I wasn't bothered because I was Manchester City. And But we have to have little, we have to have a bit of fun, don't we, Ricky? Part of the getting better.
So the PlayStation's obviously something that you're getting some pleasure out of. Yeah. And I've seen you've been on Facebook as well, talking to people.
Yeah, a few times.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It must be nice to make contact with people and
good
chat.
To be social again.
Yeah. That's good. And Dave, in terms of since Ricky's been back, what changes have you had to make at home to accommodate Ricky now?
Well, the house is quite small, really, and we've not really been able to make many improvements, just handrails. Ricky will not get in his wheelchair, so we've not had to have any alterations with the doors to get the wheelchair in, because he just will not get in his wheelchair. Which is a good thing, I think, because it's determined. The only alterations we've had to put in was an handrail to get him up the stairs. They've offered him a stairlift, but he will not get in a stairlift. He's just so determined to walk upstairs, which is in itself a task. But he manages it. Obviously, I'm behind him, holding him, and it's good exercise for him, and he manages it. It's a little bit different coming downstairs, but while they're there, we'll use them, won't we?
And that's down to you being determined to do as much as you can yourself.
Yeah, that's right. I want to make a full recovery. Yeah.
So in terms of things that you could do in the house for Ricky, you know, is there anything that you wanting to do, but you're not able to at the moment?
Yeah, ideally, we would like an extra room up for Ricky, where everything's one level, just to make things a little bit easier for him. But like I say, at the moment, we're just getting on with it, and it's it's doing him good, but I think as time goes by it might slightly get harder or it might get easier, we don't know. But like I say, ideally it would be nice for him to have his own space as well, you know.
And in terms of the changes you've had to make with your own life, are you still working, or are you able to
I've left work now, and I'm Ricky's full-time carer, and I think you're pretty chuffed about that, aren't you?
Yeah.
We still have our banter. We're still father and son.
Yeah.
We can still have our little bits of fun on the PlayStation, can't we?
Yeah.
He was offered a carer, but he didn't want anyone else to do it. Very dignified man.
Mm. I think anybody who's seen you and Ricky together at Speedway would know what a close relationship you've got, and we understand that.
Yeah, it's been a blast, hasn't it, Ricky?
Yeah,
we've had some good journeys, some bad journeys on the way home from meetings when things didn't go too well.
Yeah,
but that's the same with every rider.
Yeah,
you have your good times and you have your bad times.
Yeah, you do.
And when it's good, it's good, and when it's bad, it's bad. And when things like this happen, it just makes things even, you know. Everything in the past is just irrelevant now, isn't it? And it's just we're looking forward to getting you as strong as we can.
Yeah.
Like I say, you are, because you've come a long way. He's come a long way.
Yeah.
And I'm glad, you know, we didn't lose him, you know.
Absolutely, yeah.
And the Speedway community's tried to do something for you. I mean, I know it was an emotional night up at Berwick last year when we went up there.
Yeah.
But for you, that must have been hard.
Yeah, I had to do it. I had to go to that meeting. It was it was very hard. It was, I couldn't even speak on the night, and I couldn't believe the amount of people that turned out. It was fantastic. Obviously, Ricky was still in his coma at that time. And that was the first time I'd left his bedside. But I felt I owed it to everybody that went to the meeting. I had to be there, even though I couldn't speak. I couldn't even swallow, let alone talk. But it was fantastic to see how everybody rallied round and turned up on a cold night in Berwick. And the racing was great, and it was all for Rick here. I just wish you could have been there and seen it, Rick.
Mm.
I know you've seen the video, but it was a great occasion.
Yeah.
And when everybody claps you, it gives you...
Yeah.
I think it was a minute applause before the meeting started.
Yeah. Wow.
It was very hard not to get emotional with that. And all I kept thinking about was how, you know... It was just fantastic, Ricky.
Yeah.
It was a great bunch of people up there. Well, everywhere. Yeah. You've been fantastic.
I think there's a lot of love for Ricky in the Speedway world. I think, you know, you've been very popular with the fans all your career, haven't you? So I think, for me, it wasn't a surprise that people came out and wanted to support you.
Yeah.
It was a great night. And and just progressing on, obviously next season in March, you've got your testimonial.
Yeah.
You'll be able to go to that one.
Yeah.
So that'll be nice for you to actually be part of that.
Yeah, I am. I'm forward to it, yeah. It'll be nice to see everyone again. And it will be nice, yeah.
Yeah, I think everybody would be really pleased to see you there, just as much as you'll be pleased to see people there.
Yeah.
And Dave, hopefully we're going to get a cracking field there and a big crowd.
Oh, that'd be fantastic. I mean, that was where Ricky cut his teeth, really. People say he learnt his trade at Bellevue on the small track, but I think he only had about 3-4 second halves, and Neil Machin seen him and snapped him up, and that's where he learnt to race his bike. And he loved it. He loved it at Sheffield, didn't you, Ricky?
Yeah.
And it's just a shame that you can't ride in your own meeting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like. Sometimes you don't have a say in the matter, but I would imagine it'll be a really good day, and I'm looking forward to it.
Dave, I saw that Ricky had been down the pub with you the other day.
Yeah, the rehab team, what working with Ricky, said to us it would be good if you could sort of getting back into the community somehow. I thought the best possible way to do that would be for him to see all his old friends in the local pub where they have a band on, to get him out, get a bit of fresh air, get him out of the house, and try and socialise, kill two birds with one stone, because there was still a lot of people that haven't seen Ricky since he's been out of hospital. So I thought it'd be great for us to all go to one area, at the pub, obviously, no better place, and meet all his old friends. And he really enjoyed it. It was a good way of getting back out into the community with him and socialising with people. Also, we need to do this more for him so that it's not too much for his testimonial. Because if we're stuck at home from now till the testimonial, he'd be totally overwhelmed if he's not met groups of people before then. And I think it's a good way of getting him slowly, once every 2 weeks, into society again. I know it sounds the wrong way. I'm waffling a bit here, but it was a great occasion for him, and everybody was so happy, even though there was a few tears. It was lovely for Ricky to see a lot of people.
And although Ricky's come a long way, there's still quite a long way to go, isn't there?
Oh yeah, there's a hell of a long way to go, yeah. Ricky can't walk on his own. He's lost all his balance, so he can stand and balance, but as soon as he takes one foot off the ground to walk, he'll fall, so you've got to hold him. Even a walker isn't good enough, because he'll just fall with that. So you've got to steady him. He uses me as his walking stick, which I don't mind. I'm about the right size for one. And he totally refuses to get in his wheelchair, which some people think he needs to, but Ricky's determined not to, which is a good thing in my book. And I think he's doing really, really well. But he's still got a long, long way to go, and we don't know how far that will go, you know. The physios are happy, like I say. While he is improving, they'll keep helping him. But as soon as he stops improving, they'll stop, and they've said that. You know, they don't waste any money. But like I said before, it's a bonus every time we go. And they say, we'll see you next week, means that he's improving.
Yeah.
Which is great, and it's fun.
Well, it's been great chatting to you. It'll be fantastic to see you next March in Sheffield. Yeah. And thank you for talking to us.
Yeah, you too.
All right.
Oh,
yeah.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thanks. Yeah, cheers.
Yeah.
Well, stand up for us, Ash. Well done. All right.